physically very clean. Their homes, bodies, and clothes are always spotless, as a requirement of verse 4 and 5 of Surah 74, which says, "Purify your clothes, shun all filth." They try to make the places they are in similar to the elegant environment of paradise described in the Quran. The food they eat is also clean, as a requirement of verse 172 of Surah 2 that says, "You who believe, eat of the good things we have provided for you." God has stressed in a number of verses what believers' ideal cleanliness should be. One of these reads, "Do not associate anything with me and purify my house for those who circle it, and those who stand and bow and prostrate." What does moral cleanliness mean? In the Quran, God states that people should be morally clean too. It is stated that he who avoids the evil of his soul and purifies it will succeed. God states in Surah 91, verse 8-9, "The self and what proportioned it and inspired it with depravity and the fear of God, he who purifies it has succeeded, he who covers it up has failed." Moral purity is attainable, as we are informed in the verse, when a person avoids the evil that his soul commands him to commit. Someone who is morally pure has a sincere faith and a peaceful spirit. All his thoughts, as all his deeds, are righteous. In every event he encounters, he behaves in a manner that shows that he is well pleased with God. He is sincere and genuine. He well knows that there is definitely goodness in everything God creates. Such people are purified from the corruption of their souls. God heralds the good end that these people will meet in Surah 35, verse 18. "Whoever is purified for himself alone. God is your final destination." How is the care of orphans described in the Quran? Verse 9 of Surah 93 commands people to be compassionate towards orphan children and to treat them kindly with the words, "So as for orphans, do not oppress them." In other verses, God commands people to respect orphans' rights, to set aside a part of their goods and income for them, and to treat them well. Furthermore, he recommends that assets belonging to orphans be used justly, and that these should be returned to them when they reach mental maturity. God advises people in the Quran to be careful and meticulous over orphans' education so that they should be brought up as good servants to God and have the good morals of the Quran. He encourages believers to bring up orphans by providing them with protection and material assurance. They will ask you about the property of orphans. Say, "Managing it in their best interests is best. If you mix your property with theirs, they are your brothers." A believer always avoids any injustice towards orphans' property, because God has defined the pitiless behavior of those who covet the property of orphans and benefit from it as a serious crime and oppression. Give orphans their property, and do not substitute bad things for good. Do not assimilate their property into your own. Doing that is a serious crime. Because of all these, believers protect orphans' property carefully until they grow up and are able to care for themselves, and hand over all their rights to them when they are grown up. On the other hand, those who violate the rights of orphans and cause them distress and suffering are people with no fear of God. God has this to say about such people in the Quran. Have you seen him who denies religion? He is the one who harshly rebuffs the orphan and does not urge the feeding of the poor. Is it proper to complain about a disease, disability, poverty, or physical defect?